there. Today I'm going to answer a shout out video tag started by Shannon Green, and I watched the one by Sigrid Soto, Secret Soto, this morning, so I thought, well, I better get busy and do mine because I said I would do it. And I want to do it because I just love shout outs. I love supporting the art community on YouTube. I think it's a very good thing to do. Also, I'm not going outside today to do my sketching because you want to see what's outside my window? Most of the time my blind is closed, but I opened my blind today, but it's a foggy day out. I can't see much. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning. The fog is not supposed to lift until about 10 around here. You can kind of see over in the corner over here, I still got a little red maple bush and some evergreen trees that stay evergreen all through the winter. And if you look way off into the distance there, there's a little pond, but you probably can't see much with the fog. So anyway, I'm staying inside today and I am going to get some art done. I am working on a tag for Mixed Media Moments for her travel challenge. I promise that I will get this tag done today and mailed out tomorrow. I'll give you a sneak peek though. Her travel challenge was, where in the world would you like to go? And my choice is Wisconsin, where I'm from. And I just want more time. I want more time to explore Wisconsin because there's so much to explore. So I'm working on that tag and I hope to get this tag finished today. But I'm squishing everything off so that I can do the shout out tag. Now over here I have this big roll of paper. Doodle paper, I call it. I don't know where I got it. I think I got it at the hardware store. It could be craft store. But I noticed Shannon used a big roll of scratchy brown craft paper to do hers. And she did all her fancy writing. So I got out some Biggie markers because I really do think that I first heard about the Biggie markers from Shannon Green. When I very first signed on to YouTube, one of the first channels that I started watching was... And let's start. Oh, and I got this Copic marker for $2 at Michael's. And I don't use Copics that much. And this is a big wide one. So I thought I'd get it in here. So my first channel that I watch will be Shannon. And I'm going to have to do a double line here. Green. And let's outline this. Mine won't be as fancy as Shannon's because I'm doing it while I'm talking to you and I am using dry markers, which are going to run dry as I write on here. Let's see if my other black works any better. Shannon. Shannon Green. As Sigrid said, everybody knows Shannon Green. I like Shannon. She participated in our journal page swap last year when we had a swap. That group is now closed, but always enjoyed seeing the things that she came up with because they were always so unique. So Shannon Green, you're there. Now, I thought what I would do, you see I have my computer over here, and you probably can't see it. But on my phone, my history on my YouTube channel on my phone, I had to reinstall my YouTube app, and it erased all my history. So I have to go, it didn't erase it on my YouTube site, so I have to go to my PC to see what I've been watching. So I have my PC here, so I'm just going to go down. And, of course, the first one is Shannon Green. Then, the second one because I watched it this morning was we'll just do this really fast. Well, who do you think? Because I watched her shout out video, it's the second one on my list, and that would be Secret Soto. And I like Sigrid. She did these big, huge buttons out of a can lid, and I just love them. She used it for on her journal page cover to as a closure, and I really, really do like. She also inspired me to use my drop paper. I'm not good with drop papers. I usually put all my extra paint in my stained glass journal if I when I save it, if I save it and when I save it. So my drop papers very rarely get used, but I had this one that was made out of resin, and I collaged all my scrap papers on it and then painted over that, and they ended up being tags for a swap, and Sigrid's collaged papers inspired that. Now I am just chattering away here while I'm doing fancy. I pulled the wrong marker. I guess you get rid of that one. Secret. So, Sigrid, you inspired my tags, and I love the big button videos that she's doing. And she, on her video that I watched this morning, she's making some, I think she said hairpins out of her little fingernail polish flowers. All my black markers are getting used. So there's two. And then as I go down my watch history list, I have watched Kim Reed was my next one. Kim, love Kim's channel. And I really like it that Kim, I like to hear her talk while she works on her projects. Kim, all my markers are going dry. This may have not been such a great idea. And I'm just wanting to really fast scribble these on here while I'm talking to you. Kim Reed. So Shannon Green, Secret Soto, Kim Reed. Those are the three most recent channels that I like. Kim does beautiful work. She was a guest designer at Treasure Deluxe. Trésor Deluxe, which sells a lot of laces that I can't afford, and now she's most recently done some altered dominoes and some tiles that she covered with resin, and she is a guest designer at Spare Marbles, I believe. So, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful work. The next one down that I watched most recently is, and I'll try to keep these halfway decent. Grammy. And I'm sure a lot of you have watched these channels, that they are not really all that new to most of you, because I get these channels from you. Grammy to Bay. BAY. And I like Grammy's channel. She does a lot of haul videos, but she also is just she's just plain good at conversation. It's just like she's sitting across having a cup of coffee with me. And I always like to hear what's on her mind. So I do watch her channel quite a bit. I like to see what she comes up with. Grammy to Bay. And I'm gonna have to roll this up on the other side here. Let's see. Another channel that I watch a lot is, whoops. Not all of them are art channels. Oh, I can't forget this one. Because she is definitely one of my favorite artists, and that's, hope I spell your name right, Giselle. Grenier. Giselle is a Canadian artist from Canada. She's a Canadian artist from Canada. Giselle does a lot of portraiture art professionally and animal portraits. Beautiful, beautiful detailed work. She also just started on Facebook group the 365 Art a Day project, where you are encouraged to work at least 15 minutes a day on art. And I find that I do that, but I started a 365 a day art journal, and I'm finding that all my swaps and projects like this kind of put my journal work into the background, and that frustrates me. Another one that I watch a lot is B. Sorry for the bad printing here. What did I do with? Oh, be creative. Here, let me. Well, B. See, I'm C R. I believe it's E. I hope I got this right. 8 I V B creative 2. What I'm looking at on the screen is her other channel, which is the I believe it's Studio Silver Creek. Leanne, I hope I got this right. Studio. Studio. We'll just make this a doodle. Silver. Creek. Leanne does beautiful work. Better work than I'm doing printing here. Silver. Because I'm trying to talk and draw at the same time, and I'd like to say I'm good at that, but sometimes I gotta shut up and think about what I'm doing. And we'll just kind of make a little. Leanne, what I like about Leanne's videos is they're short and they're sweet and they're good, and I can never seem to do that. I I have to use fast forwards to get everything that I want to say on there. Then a couple channels that I watch. Is one channel that I watch a lot. One of the artists got me to watching this, and that's the Shaytards. Yes, I watch the Shaytards. Maybe they'll do some art videos. the most recent video, they're running a marathon. I think Shay Carl. In New York, and it's going to benefit the Ebola money that they're raising is going to go to benefit Ebola. Next one down is, and I'm just taking these in the order is coming down my history, so these are the most recent ones that I watched, is Linda. And everybody knows Linda's Arcads. Linda Lopatka. Love her Arcads. I try to watch them every day. Some days I miss, but then I go back and make it up. Linda lives not too far from me, and I actually met her in a Tuesday morning. She was going through the Graphic 45 paper stack. We ended up splitting Graphic 45 papers. Next one down that I watched is, I think I'll take the blue again, Rita Marie. Rita does that beautiful gypsy art. And I am just scribbling on this here. But Rita Marie, I watched your channel as often as I can. Marie, which is about every video that you come out with. Josie, I say Giotto. Gitto. Josie is from Italy. I love to hear Josie talk about, and what I like too about, I like Josie's accent. I think Josie is originally from Canada, but she certainly got picked up her Italian accent. I won't give you everybody on my subscription list. These are just the top ones that I've watched here in the last few days. And then I'm going to pop a couple more of my favorites on there. Josie Gitto. I watched this one, and I do not watch this one all the time, but he's on my history list next. And this is an artist. I think he's a professional artist. Michael Lang. And the video that I watched popped up on my screen. So would I say I watch this one all the time? No, probably not. But I did watch him. He did a ribbon painting technique, and I thought that was interesting. And then I watched Miss Lady Petals. Miss Lady Petal. Crazy Island Family. She does all those, coordinates all those wonderful letter art journals, and how she keeps track of all that and keeps everybody in line is beyond me. But what I like about, we call her PETA, P-E-T-A. What I like about Miss Lady Petal is her laugh. I love to hear her chuckle laugh and her Australian accent. So she does a blog toward the end of the week, almost every week. I like watching her. I love her. I love her channel. I love her letter journals. She inspires me. Cat Hand recently did a video on crochet. She did a demonstration video of how to chain and the single crochet for her sister. And I've crocheted almost my entire life. But I thought she did an excellent tutorial. So if you want to learn how to crochet, you might start out by going over and watching Cat Hand's channel. She does beautiful cards, beautiful mixed media, gorgeous work. Kathy's her name, but she goes by Cat Hand. Next one down is, yes, I'm going to call him Victor, because I can't pronounce his name either. B-I-T. Oh, I'm sorry, it's B-I-K. I'm sorry, Victor, it's B-I-K. T. Of course, there'll be links below. So even though I'm scribbling on here, I'm just scribbling on here while I'm talking. You can go to all the links below in the description box below and find these channels. And I can't even draw his last name. I'd really like to know what this stands for, Victor. This looks like an A to me, but I'm probably not an A in your language. A-H, and then backwards N, very artistic, and then I-B, and people call him Victor, and Shannon Green watches his channel a lot, and of course that's how we all found Victor, and he does beautiful work. A lot of upcycling. He was on Shannon's shout out list.